A few years ago, we showed you a 20 LED roulette board that was designed by our partners in Korea, ITIZ. Today, we're taking the design and using Nova to transform this traditional PCB into a flexible one. The first layer is printed with ACI material, Semi-Sintering Conductive Ink, FS0142, on Normandy Coatings, Arcophane, TCA082F. A heat-stabilized PET with a silica adhesion promoter. We're leaving specific areas blank on this layer where the dielectric will be dispensed in the next step. For the dielectric, we're using ACI Materials Stretchable Printed Insulator Ink, SI3104. When choosing a dielectric for a flexible PCB, it's important to ensure that it's both flexible and chemically compatible with the ink you're using. With the dielectric dispensed, we're ready to print the crossovers, again using ACI Materials Semi-Sintering Conductive Ink. Because the substrate tolerates the lower reflow temperature and extended time in the oven, we can use solder paste to attach the components, similar to a rigid PCB. Flexible PCBs present a unique challenge as they consist of flexible substrates with printed circuits and also include attached components. As a result, a key consideration with flexible PCBs is to ensure that rigid components remain attached when the substrate is flexed. To solve for this, we've chosen smaller components that will better resist flexing. The components are then encapsulated in a UV curing resin to reinforce the areas they are attached on the substrate. We're using Siraya Tech Tenacious Flexible UV Curable Resin. It's important to coat as little of the substrate as possible to maintain maximum flexibility. The flexible roulette board is then attached to the ITIZ companion board, a 555 slowing down pulse generator. Each time the companion board is triggered, the LEDs on the roulette PCB light up in rapid circular sequence before slowing down and stopping on a single LED. Designing flexible printed electronics using traditional integrated circuits allows for PCBs to be lighter and conformable to different enclosures, while allowing us to access new possibilities for traditionally designed PCBs.